Dear friends, good morning. Last class we have learned about the mutual inductance, where we have individually analyzed when the only one winding is excited, what is the flux linkage in the secondary winding. Similarly, secondary winding is excited and primary winding is open, what is the flux linkages of the primary winding due to the secondary side excitation. Then finally, we end up with this: if the two windings are excited, how the mutual inductance will be, how the formula will be. Then finally, we came to know whenever the coupling coefficient is 1, it is a perfect coupling. Then whenever the coupling coefficient is greater than 0.5, a tight coupling. Then whenever the coupling coefficient is less than 0.5, it is a loose coupling. So in this lecture, I am going to explain about when that circuit breaker, how the tripping effect is happening. Then based on that, we are going to derive what are all in this voltage equation itself, what are the parameters we have to consider as this there is having a moving part. So let me share my whiteboard. I hope you can see my whiteboard. Assume there is one core like this. Core, which once I draw it, will understand what it is. So this core has air gap as well. So it should be straight line, but please bear with me. Then there is having one moving plunger. It is connected with one fixed place, which has that spring constant and dashpot as well. So we can call it. We are not going to explain anything much about this control system side of this one. So I am going to explain what all the parameters are there in the voltage component. For that, I am drawing this. So this here, this is excited with the voltage V, number of turns is N. So as this is the moving plunger, then it is having the width of 2 into W. It is having a 2 into W and depth of D. It has the depth of D. The distance is into the paper, depth of D. Then so this air gap, we can write it as G. Then this air gap also constant, same G. Then this distance we will call it as X, this gap. Then automatically, as this winding is excited, we are expecting 3 power flow, or 3 magnetic flux flow will be in the 3 places. One path will be due to this side flux path, Then another one will be, it will start from here and coming here. Then another one path will be, this is the entire about this tree, about this entire core. About this entire core. So we have this flux intensity, I am writing it as H2, and the flux moving this side, I am writing it as H1, and this can be H3. So now I am going to explain now directly Ampere's circuital law. In this Ampere's circuited law of this both these three paths, for example, I can tell this is can be the path 1 and this can be path 2, then outer path can be P3. Now I am writing Ampere's law. What is Ampere's law? Line integral law. H dot dl in the closed contour equal to current enclosed n into I. So now, for example, for first path, what happened? H2 is entering and G is coming here. The magnetic it will coming through here. Better I can use another one color so that you can easily understand. So it will come out and it is going here and coming out. This is the one flux. So line integral, already assume that one more thing, that permeability of this material is infinity. Permeability of the material is infinity means there is no reluctance in the magnetic core. So if this, there is no reluctance in the magnetic, so what core means, that how the there is no reluctance in the magnetic core, reluctance is equal to L by mu in the area. Therefore, if the permeability is infinity, automatically reluctance will be infinity. So we have used such a material by reducing the reluctance, and whenever this is excited, this plunger will move downwards. Whenever this is the excitation is not there, automatically the plunger will move up. This is the concept. So now, according, for example, for path 1, how assume the reluctance of the core is not there, only the reluctance of the air gap only. So accordingly, we can write magnetic flux density intensity of this path is H2. So we can write H2 in the length of the air gap is here x, plus magnetic path of this magnetic field intensity is H1, and the length of the air gap is G, that is equal to N into I. That is the equation number 1. Then path 2, we are assuming that the flux linkages are moving like this. Then path 2, this is our path 2. Path 2, I can use another one color, red color. So this is our path 2. Path 2. In this path 2, what about this flux linkage now for path 2? We can write H2 into X plus H3 in the air gap is equal to number of turns into I. So this is our second equation. H2 into G plus H3 into air gap, H3 into equal to N into I. So this is the second equation. So from this, automatically we can have another one equation also. What about the path 3 equation? Path 3, I can use another one color. So path 3, in this path 3 equation will be, path 3 is nothing but this is the path 3 total flux linkage. So here only it will be concentrated G and this G, H1 and H3. So we can have H1 into G plus H3. So here H1 is this direction and H2 is in opposite direction. So we can write like this. There is no number of turns in the current. Magnetic flux linkage is not there. So we can write now here H3 into air gap minus H1 into air gap equal to zero. This is our equation 3. So from this equation 3, we can have H1 is equal to H3. We can have H1 is equal to H3. This is the assumptions we have made it. H1 is equal to H3. Then, yeah, this is the equation of, from this we can conclude that H1 is equal to H3. Then finally, we are going to write Gauss's law equation. What is Gauss's law equation of the surrounding of this plunger? Gauss's law equation, I will take another one color. This surrounding of the plunger. Surrounding of the plunger. In the surrounding of the plunger, if I draw separately, we have the plunger like this. So one magnetic field intensity here H2, then another one is leaving here H1, and another one from here it will be H3. So accordingly, what is the Gauss's law in the surface integral of magnetic flux density in the n gap into ds is equal to zero. So if we write like this, this is nothing but area. So in this area, this is splitted into this left side, this will be splitted into right side, path 1 and path 2. So this entire 2w, the width is dividing here w separately, then here it is dividing here w separately. So how we can write now in this plunger, H2 is entering. So this is our 2W. So here it is moving, then H2 is moving here as well. So how we can write this equation now? H1. So H1 has the, this is H1, H2 is the sum. It is splitted into H3 and H1. And so this H3 and H1 equally dividing the flux linkage. So how we can write now magnetic flux density? If you write it now, for example, I am writing now H2. We know that B is equal to mu naught into H. I will write the H equation later. I am going to write this magnetic flux density. So we can write now magnetic flux density of B2 into area 2W into the depth. So 2W is width and D is the depth of the core plus then we can write here, this is entering and these two are leaving. So instead of plus, we have to write it here minus. So the minus, then H3 means B3 into width will be divided into W and here W. So we can write W into width, depth minus B1 into W into D is equal to zero. So from this, we can write this equation in terms of field intensity. So mu naught H2 into 2WD minus mu naught H3 into WD minus mu naught H1 into WD equal to zero. So accordingly, already we end up with this equation, this third equation, H1 is equal to H3. So one can write directly mu naught H2 into 2WD minus mu 2 mu naught H1 W into D equal to zero. So then if we equate this equation 3, equation 1 and this equation 4, if you solve equation 1 and equation 4, we can have write it as h1 equal to h2 equal to ni divided by g plus x. H1 equal to h2 is equal to ni divided by g plus x. So then now I am going to find my aim is what is the voltage induced, what is the voltage equation, total voltage equation. So now I am going to write this flux equation. After the flux equation, I will go and write this equation of flux linkage. Then once I know the flux linkage, I can write the voltage equation V is equal to rate of change of flux linkage with respect to time. So that we can write this equation as H1 and H2 already we know what is the value. So now already we end up with this equation H1 and H2 is equal to NL by. What is mean by flux, magnetic flux density? Magnetic flux density is nothing but, flux divided by area. From this, flux is nothing but magnetic flux density in the area. So now we already know what is mean by magnetic flux density. I am going to explain what is the voltage induced in this, what is the voltage, total voltage effect with respect to flux linkage. So now we have to concentrate only the magnetic field intensity of H2 alone. So we can write flux is nothing but mu naught into H2, since this is the source to generate the flux. Since the winding is placed here, we are exciting here. So only I have to write the flux generated is mu naught into H2. In the area of the core, how we can write area of the core? 2W into D. How 2W into D? This is 2W. And similarly, this also 2W. Depth will be D. So we can write it as equation. Then the number of tangents also N. So what is a flux linkage lambda? Lambda is equal to n into phi. So we can write it as n into phi, n mu naught 2 WD into H2. Already we know H2 is equal to ni by g into x, ni by g plus s. So that we can write it as mu naught, we can write 2 mu omega d mu naught n square I divided by g. So 1 minute, there is no space. I hope you understood what I am saying. B I have substituted. I want to know what is the total voltage in terms of what are the parameters in the included in the voltage. So that I have written now lambda is equal to n into phi. So n into phi, we can directly, I will write it here instead of taking lengthy derivations. So n into phi, so that we can write now n into phi is already there. Phi is in terms of H2. H2 already, this equation will provide H2, fifth equation. So we can directly write lambda is nothing but 2 omega d mu naught n square I by g plus x. X is nothing but the distance travel. Based on the magnetic field effect, supply voltage here, this distance, the plunger attraction will change. So the repulsion and attraction will be changed. Automatically the distance x will change. So g plus x. So already we know this equation. So already we know this equation. How lambda is equal to n into phi. Already we know lambda is equal to n into phi or lambda is equal to n into phi or n into I. So then we can substitute here. In this case, if you take, if you write this equation, if you come to know this sixth equation, these parameters are inductance parameters and these parameters are current. So we can write, and if you make it, so if you make it, lambda is equal to L into I, L into I, lambda equal to N into phi or L into I. So we have already lambda in terms of I. So we have lambda Lx, that means inductance is nothing but 2 omega d mu naught n square divided by g plus x. What is x? The distance. So from this we can conclude that inductance vary with respect to the distance. If the distance is zero, inductance will be more. Then if the distance is more, automatically the inductance effect will reduce, so that we can come to know this lambda L is nothing but this one. So now I am directly substituting the value of voltage. I am going to derive this voltage equation directly. So how we can write this voltage equation is, we know voltage is nothing but d lambda by dt. Already we know lambda is nothing but L of x into I. So now we can substitute here, voltage is nothing but here d by dt of L of x into I. Now we have to differentiate with the inductance. Since the inductance is not constant, it is keep on varying with respect to the distance of x. So what we can write, we have to differentiate in this two terms by using UV forms, so that we can write this equation as L of x into di divided by dt plus I into d L of x divided by dt into, now we have to differentiate with respect to distance, dx by dt. Since dx is the variable, so I have to write first differentiate that inductance, then the parameters of the inductance is varying with respect to x, so that I have to differentiate with this, differentiate dx by dt. So now if you do like this, one can try with this equation how the value will be. So better I can take a new screen. So already we end up with L of x is equal to 2 omega d, so 2 wd mu naught n square divided by g plus x divided by x. So again I have written the voltage equation is d lambda divided by dt. So but the lambda is nothing but L of x into I. So L is not constant, it is variable with respect to distance. So now d lambda divided by dt can be written as L of x into di divided by dt plus I into d L of x divided by dt into dx by dt. So accordingly, if you do like this, finally we can have the voltage equation 2 omega d mu naught n square divided by g plus x into di divided by dt plus divided by dt, then minus 2 omega d mu naught n square into I divided by g plus x the whole square into dx divided by dt. So from this, this can be write it as transformer voltage. This can be write it as speed voltage. Write it as speed voltage. What is transformer voltage? Normally we will write V is equal to L into di by divided by dt. So if there is no stationary part, there is a stationary part only, there is no moving part, automatically the dx by dt will not come to the picture. Dx by dt will be zero. So it will be come to the stationary voltage, transformer voltage alone. At the same time, if there is a moving part in this magnetic field, that inductance value will vary with respect to the distance of travel, distance of movement. Accordingly, there is having two terms, transformer voltage and as well as speed voltage. So this can be applicable for linear motion as well as our rotating electrical machines also. So with this, I would like to conclude today's lecture. From this lecture, what we have learned is, if there is only the stationary part and there is no static part, there is no moving part, or there is the voltage have only transformer voltage alone. At the same time, if there is a moving part, automatically it has the transformer voltage as well as speed EMF, or otherwise speed voltage. So one should analyze that electromagnetic circuit, where there any transformer static part or there any moving part, accordingly we should analyze and come to the conclusion that the system should have transformer voltage as well as speed voltage for moving, which if the system is having moving part, otherwise only it will have the transformer. That is what we end up with this. We have derived this much derivations from the starting. What is the voltage equation? I hope this is, even though this is little bit derivation, but it is interesting. One can understand what are the effects of electromagnetic circuits. I hope it is very much understandable. So wish you all the best. Thank you.